આ પ્રોગ્રામના પ્રાયોજક છે નીલકંઠ પતંગ હોટલ.
નમસ્કાર દર્શક મિત્રો, રિપોર્ટમાં બધાનું સ્વાગત છે. દર્શક મિત્રો, આજે એક એવો વિષય લઈને આવ્યા છે આપની સામે કે નોર્મલી આ વિષય પ્રત્યે કદાચ લોકો સુગ ધરાવતા હોય છે, અથવા તો પછી આજે જેની વાત કરવાના છે તેને ખૂબ જ ઘૃણાસ્પદ રીતે તેના નામનો ઉલ્લેખ થતો હોય છે. જનરલી જ્યારે પણ વાત ચાલતી હોય છે, એકબીજા ઉપર જ્યારે ગુસ્સે થતા હોય છે, ઇવન એક ડાયલોગ પણ હિન્દી ફિલ્મ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રીઝમાં ખૂબ જ કોમન થઈ ગયો હતો, કુત્તે મેં તેરા ખૂન પી જાઉંગા. દર્શક મિત્રો, આજે વાત કરવી છે કુત્તાઓની, મીન્સ ડોગ્સની. નોર્મલી ડોગ્સ અલગ અલગ કેટેગરીઝમાં આપણે વહેંચી નાખેલા છે. ઘરમાં આપણું પરિવારની જેમ રહેતું, સભ્યની જેમ રહેતું એક ડોગી, કદાચ તેના મૃત્યુ બાદ પરિવારજનો, બિલકુલ પોતાના કોઈ પરિવારના સદસ્ય જાણે એના ઘરેથી જતું રહ્યું હોય કે વિદાય લઈ લીધું હોય, તેટલું દુઃખ સતત જીવનભર તે લોકો અનુભવતા હોય છે. અને એવી જ રીતે કૂતરાઓની બીજી જાત હોય છે જે સ્ટ્રીટ ડોગ્સ હોય છે, જે લોકો રોડ ઉપર, શેરીઓમાં, ગલીઓમાં, શહેરમાં, નગરની અંદર તેઓ ફરતા હોય છે. સ્ટ્રીટ ડોગ્સ અને ઘરમાં પાળેલો ડોગ બંને ડોગ જ છે, પરંતુ આપણો નજરિયો બદલાઈ જાય છે કે આપણા ઘરમાં રહેતું ડોગ એ આપણા ફેમિલી મેમ્બરની જેમ લાગે છે, પરંતુ સ્ટ્રીટ ડોગની વાત આવે છે ત્યારે આપણે તેને હળદૂત કરતા હોઈએ છીએ. આ જ વિષયની ચર્ચા કરવા માટે અને બિલકુલ ખાસ કરીને એક એવી વિશિષ્ટ વ્યક્તિત્વ કે જેણે પોતે સતત છેલ્લા કેટલાય સમયથી ડોગ્સ માટેનું એક આખું અભિયાન આદર્યું છે, લીસા વોર્ડન ફ્રોમ કેનેડા. લીસાજી, વેલકમ ટુ ધ શો.
થેન્ક યુ.
First of all, Lisa, I want to know what is your mission and what you are going to convey the message to the people.
Well, it happens that I really love dogs. And so it's always a little bit difficult for a foreigner when we come here because we see many of them suffering on the streets. There's also a lot of people who don't really like dogs, which is understandable because you have a rabies issue. But there are ways of managing the situation that can make it a good situation for everybody. One of these things that's very important for the city to do is to implement a very large-scale sterilization program of the dogs. What that means is the dogs get caught and there's a surgical procedure that once they go through it, they don't have any more babies. So over time, the population will slowly start to decline. This is the only legal way to address the dog situation.
That is, I wanted to know from how you inspired to do this one.
Well, I always grew up with animals and I love many animals and I especially have a place in my heart for dogs. In India, rabies is an issue, and if as we sterilize the dogs we give them also rabies vaccine, then we can decrease and get rid of the rabies problem altogether. It's a real possibility. It's not difficult. We just need a systematic scientific plan to do this, and I see that in Gujarat we have a very strong potential to make Gujarat rabies free, to make it a place where the dog population is managed by humane and compassionate methods, unlike what happens now, which is the dogs are picked up by the dog catchers with these metal tongs that are so barbaric that they often kill the dogs and they're dumped on the city outskirts. This does not solve the problem, it actually makes the problem worse. And what we need to do is pick up these dogs with nets, which is a gentle, humane way, especially here in the land of Gandhi, where we talk about ahimsa, get the dogs sterilized, get them vaccinated, and gradually decrease the dog population, and make these dogs so that they do not cause a problem for humans.
I wanted to stop here. દર્શક મિત્રો, એક એવી વાત કરું કે એક જે અત્યાર સુધી વાતમાં જે હું પૂછવા માંગુ છું, બેઝિકલી કે એક રસપ્રદ કિસ્સો, એક સ્ટ્રીટ ડોગ એમની નજરે પડ્યું અને ઘાયલ સ્ટ્રીટ ડોગ્સ, અને ત્યારબાદ તેમણે સ્ટ્રીટ ડોગ ની મૂવી ઉતારીને તેમણે ઇન્ટરનેટ પર મોકલ્યું. અને કદાચ સરપ્રાઈઝ થશે આપને કે બહારના દેશમાંથી સીધો જ તેમની ઉપર મેલ આવ્યો અને તેને મદદ કરવા માટેની પોતાની ભાવના રજૂ કરી. લીઝા, Tell us the story about your street dog, where you put on the website, and you got the tremendous response.
Yes. Well, one day in at my home, there was a very small puppy in very bad condition, almost dead.
Can you tell me a proper location of your home?
Near Shilaj village, out on the west side of the city. And this puppy was in terrible shape, almost dead. And I couldn't pass him by. I just picked him up and brought him home. And we gave him medicine and food, and we gave him a bath. And within a week, he was starting to look better. But already, I have three Indian street dogs that I've adopted. Like my children, the dogs are to me. And so we brought this puppy home. We couldn't keep him because we can't have more than three, because one day we have to fly away in the plane. We take the dogs. It's too expensive to take all these dogs. So I decided, okay, I'll make a video of this dog. He's really beautiful. Put him on the internet. And what happened was, he went around the world on YouTube, and a lady in Canada saw him, and she contacted me by email. He was on a website that was about the Indian dog. She saw him on this website about the Indian pariah dog, because many people overseas, they love these dogs. And she contacted me, and she asked if she could adopt him, and I said, of course you can. And so he went to Canada. And then she sent us pictures of him in the snow, this Gujarati Ahmedabadi dog playing in the snow, he absolutely loves it, and he's got a wonderful life, and I just hope that people here will see how wonderful their own Desi dogs are, and that they will also consider making these dogs part of their family.
Lisa, before started our talk show, you said the Indian dogs have a special breed, and that is a rather, you can say, this is something different than other than other world.
Absolutely. One thing that a lot of people don't know is that Indian dogs, now many of them have some mixed blood. However, most of them have a lot of this pariah dog. It's Indian pariah dog is the name of the breed. And this is a breed that we need to be proud of. It's one of the oldest dog breeds known to mankind. They found the skull of an Indian pariah dog at Mohenjo-Daro. And the Indian dog is also portrayed in the caves at Ajanta. That should show you this breed of dog is far older than any Labrador that costs so much money to buy, than Doberman. And why aren't we proud of these dogs? You know, be a millionaire, adopt a slum dog. That's what I say. Be proud of your Indian dogs. They're wonderful. They're intelligent. They're robust. Why not take an Indian dog? That's what I say.
See, so many people are afraid of the biting of dogs. And that's why this is the basic reason why the street dog, they are avoiding the street dogs. Rather they are hitting them, or they are going to call any civic department, corporation, see we have a dog, just go and catch it. What do you say? How citizen can reply to this dog? How can they go close, closer with dogs? What would be the solution?
Well, I have never been bitten by a street dog. Dogs are very intelligent. They know who their friends are. I say, if you're kind to that street dog, you have a friend for life. Take a biscuit. Bend down. A dog doesn't like it when you're standing up so far away. Squat down on the ground. Don't look him in the eye. Just make a nice noise. Give him a biscuit. After some time, he will realize that he can trust you. He will be your friend for life. And people just need to learn to make friends with dogs. Usually people are afraid because their parents taught them to be afraid. Dogs are the best friends you can ever have. Have you ever met a corrupt dog? No, he's not going to betray you. So this is, it's just an education thing. Dogs are very good friends to humans.
Now that the civic body, they are using, you said, metal, rod, and what is your analysis? How many dogs, rather go by percentage-wise, how many dogs are being injured or going to death with the system of...
Well, the tongs exert so much pressure on the internal organs that it results in internal bleeding. And it's impossible to operate, do the sterilization on dogs that are caught with tongs because their internal organs are damaged. So we can't help them. Up to 50% of the dogs caught with tongs will die. And so this needs to stop. There's many ways to do it that are not difficult. Just catch the dog in a net. Doesn't hurt the dog. And then don't dump the dog outside the city. Take the dog to the NGO that does the sterilization. Get the dog sterilized. And the law of India says you have to put him back in the place where he came from. And there's a good reason. It's not just because this is how it is. If a dog is vaccinated and sterilized and it's in its neighborhood, it protects the people in that neighborhood from other unvaccinated dogs coming in. So even if you don't like dogs, the dog is your friend because he's protecting you from rabies. He's also keeping the rat population down because he competes with the rat for food. The dog is stronger than the rat. The dog gets most of the garbage. The rat population stays down. Also, dogs hunt rats. Now, we all know that in Surat in the 90s, hundreds of people died from bubonic plague. This was after the municipal commissioner ordered the killing of thousands of dogs. What happens when you do that? The rat population comes up, and bubonic plague, you can't stop it. And so what you need is to understand is dogs are your friends. They protect from rabies once they're vaccinated. They keep the rats down. If the rats are down, the snakes are down. They keep the monkeys in the trees. They are a good friend to have. It doesn't. If you don't like dogs, that's okay. You don't have to like dogs.
The cycle of nature will continue and will be stable.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Alisa, your thoughts is very noble. Very noble. No one will deny this thought. But ultimately, what you said, that will be the policy matter.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the using the net, that is a policy matter.
Yes.
Because the governing body is going to use that net. Okay. Now, have you tried to approach any civic body, any government organization? Have you tried for that?
Yes, we've been communicating with the authorities, and we are hopeful that they are going to change their methods. They are now aware that that footage, somebody took video of the dog catchers catching the dogs with these tongs and dumping them at the piranha. The footage went on the internet, and people around the world were outraged at how cruel and barbaric it was, and just how sad for these many dogs that die unnecessarily, horrible, painful deaths. I don't know if the civic body loves dogs, hates dogs, whatever, but I do know that they care that Ahmedabad looks very bad when they do things like this. They want Ahmedabad to look good. They want to be a World Heritage City. They want Sabarmati Riverfront. They want BRTS. Good. Let's also develop a better way of dealing with the dogs. A modern, compassionate, humane way so that Ahmedabad can be a world leader in this area, not just in the buses. Not just in World Heritage, also with dogs.
Lisa, I want to add something, and maybe you must be knowing that. All Hindus who is believing in Hinduism, the all god and goddess of Hindus, they have different type of animals with them. You pick any god or any goddess, they have, he or she has any animal with them. Okay, so I think there is no doubt about all Hindus are closer with the all animals, because if any Hindu lady preparing food for his family, she is cooking first roti for cow. In Hinduism, they said your first roti for cow only. Don't you think that all the Hindus are little bit closer to animal other than the people of world? Do you feel that?
Well, I think in theory they are, but when you come and see what happens here, it's sometimes difficult to believe, because sometimes I see people beating dogs, sometimes I see what's happening with them getting caught with tongs and dumping. I hope it's true, but sometimes it's hard to believe.
Now, Lisa, what is your message to our viewers?
My message is, start to think about dogs in a new way. They are your friends. They protect you from diseases. They tell you when there's burglars coming. They protect you from attack. They keep the snakes and the rats away. And they are very friendly, very friendly. All you have to do is take the first step to be kind to an animal. They know, they're very smart. They know who to trust. You take the first step, the dog will follow.
Thank you very much, Lisa, and wish you all
Thank
the best
you.
For your mission.
My pleasure.
Darshak Mitro, Lisa nu je mission chhe aakhu, Lisa Warden, exclusive, matlab je emne thought aave chhe, kadach suta, jagta, upta, besta. કન્ટિન્યુ તેમને થોટ પ્રોસેસ મારે છે કે હાઉ ટુ પ્રિવેન્ટ ધ ડોગ્સ, અથવા તો પછી તેની સાથે જે પણ ટ્રીટમેન્ટ થાય છે તેને પ્રોપર કઈ રીતે થવી જોઈએ. અને બહુ સૂચક રીતે કીધું કે ડોગ્સ છે તે ઓલરેડી આપણા ફ્રેન્ડ્સ છે અને એ ક્યારેક કરપ્ટ નહીં હોઈ શકે. તમે જો કદાચ તેને પ્રેમથી રાખશો તો ડેફિનેટલી એ તમારો કદાચ વન ઓફ ધ બેસ્ટ ફ્રેન્ડ એ બની રહેશે, તમારું ને તમારા ફેમિલીના. વિભીષ કેમણે જે પણ મિશન લીધું છે અને ખાસ કરીને જે વાત કરી છે, મુદ્દાઓ બહુ પ્રોપર કીધા છે કે ડોગ પકડવા માટેની ચલો જરૂરી છે. અમુક લોકો જે કદાચ બાઇટ કરે છે, જે લોકો કદાચ હેરાન કરે છે તેને પકડવા જોઈએ, પરંતુ પકડવાની પણ એક રીત હોય. જે પ્રમાણે મોટા કાળા લાંબા સળિયા જાડાથી જે પકડવામાં આવે છે તેના કારણે આ ડોગ્સને પકડવાની પ્રવૃત્તિ તો થઈ રહી છે, પરંતુ તેની સાથે સાથે તે ડોગને નુકસાન પણ થઈ રહ્યું છે. તેની જગ્યાએ જો નેટનો યુઝ કરવામાં આવે તો ડેફિનેટલી જે પ્રોબ્લેમ છે તે પણ સોર્ટ આઉટ થશે અને સાથે સાથે ડોગી હટ પણ નહીં થાય. વિભીષ કે તેમનું મિશન છે તે ખૂબ જ કામયાબ રહે. બધે અગેન જે વાત કરી તે પ્રમાણે આપણે બધા જ એક કોમળ હૃદયના ઇન્સાન છે અને તેના કારણે આપણી ભાવનાઓ જેટલી મનુષ્ય પ્રત્યેની કોમળી હોય છે તેટલી જ કોમળી આપણે દરેકે દરેક જાનવર પ્રત્યે પણ રાખીએ છીએ. થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ લીસા ફોર કમિંગ ટુ ધ સ્ટુડિયો. દર્શક મિત્રો, આ હતો અમારો સ્પેશિયલ રિપોર્ટ. ફરી મળીશું આવા જ એક સાથે, ત્યાં સુધી આપશો નમસ્કાર. થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ. થેન્ક્સ અ લોટ.
થેન્ક યુ.
આ પ્રોગ્રામના પ્રાયોજક છે નીલકંઠ પતંગ હોટલ.